you claim to be a follower of Jesus Christ, I would just ask you to consider the simple question. Is God calling me to something more? It may be that you're at a transition point in your life right now, okay? Graduation is coming in just a few weeks, and you have got short-timer's disease so bad you can barely contain it, right? Maybe that's you. Transition time is coming up. This would be a great time for you to stop and ask yourself, is God calling me to something more? Maybe for you, transition is on the other end of that spectrum, okay? Retirement is right around the corner. You have a calendar hanging off on your wall, and you are stroking the days, you know? You can count them, baby. It's coming. Maybe God is calling you to something more, not something less. Maybe at this time of transition in your life, God is at work in you saying, unleash the Spirit of God. There's more for you. Maybe it is that this, for some reason, and you really can't put your finger on it, but there's this uneasiness at work in your life. It's just this sense of restlessness, and you can't explain it. You just know it's there. Maybe the Spirit of God is at work in your life, and it's time to unleash the Spirit of God because God is calling you to something more. And you all, this is incredibly important. I think that every follower of Jesus Christ should just stop and consider just at least once in your life, is God calling me to engage in ministry and mission with Him? Because you all, in my view, I have never in my lifetime seen the global church in greater need of men and women to step forward in leadership than I see right now. Never seen it. And I'm just convinced that God is at work in the lives of ordinary people, and He's calling them to consider, I'm calling you to something more. I'm calling you to something more. And so this week, I just want to challenge you. Maybe for you, you're a long way from this. I certainly was when I was a 17-year-old kid leaning against the wheel of my car on the back row of a church picnic. Maybe for you, that first right step is to say, I'm going to invest and allow other people to invest in me. So I'm going to get involved in a group or T group. I'm going to cut the herd so that other people can provide me with accountability and I can learn to be vulnerable with them so that then I've got some people around me that I can say, hey, do you see God at work in my life? Do you see any way that God might be calling me to something more? Or how about this week? Maybe you're a student, you're still living at home, and you've got this godly parent or grandparent who's just been pouring into you. And you've made it your mission in life to tune out everything, every wise thing that they say. That's just like your goal. So if your parents or grandparents say something smart to you, your immediate reaction is to go, nope, you know, that's just your move. What if this week you said, you know what? Maybe God has placed this godly parent or grandparent or aunt or uncle, whomever it is for you, into my life because God is preparing me for something more. And maybe it's time I listened. Maybe you're here today and you're a parent. I just got through spending a week with my adult kids hiking through the Smoky Mountains. I have bitten my tongue off so many times in the last week, I was afraid at points I was going to bleed to death. Because I was looking at my kids and I'd want to say something, but I go, yeah, adult. You can't speak to them like they're kids anymore. That's an adult. So be quiet, which is tough for somebody like me to do because I'm paid to talk, right? But as I'm watching my kids hike with their spouses, I remember taking a hike with CJ when I had him on a baby carrier right here. And I remember I just stood there and I just watched him and his wife. And I thought, you get one shot to pour into your kids everything that you have. Do not squander it. Do not waste it. And don't convince yourself for a moment that anything is more important, because it isn't. I promise you, and your days with your kids are numbered. So pour into them and invest in them that they might catch a glimpse of the glory of God and entertain that question, is God calling me to something more? Do you not want to see your child unleash the Spirit of God in their life? You may not be able to make that decision for them, but you have influence. Don't waste it. And so maybe this week that's what you do. You double down on that idea right there. Or maybe for you this week, this is the week that you say, in my own life, I'm going to unleash the Spirit of God. I want Him to flow out of me, through me. I want Him to be evident in every relationship and every touch and every contact that I have with everyone I know. Let there be no doubt that there is more to me than just this fleshly box. But there is the power of the Spirit of God at work in my life, and I will not hide it. I will not keep it in. I'm going to be transformed by the Spirit of God because He is calling me to something more.